By Ronaldo criticising the Manchester United manager, owners and others in an interview with Piers Morgan, he has achieved two objectives. Firstly, Ronaldo has forced his employees to decide his fate, considering he is still in an enforceable contract of employment ending in the summer of 2023. And secondly, the timing of the interview may well suit his goal as the best exit strategy from that legally binding employment contract before the start of the second part of the season. And while it's obvious Ronaldo is frustrated being a peripheral figure in the team, his grievance seems to be more than this. He reportedly feels betrayed by the club, by the manner he was treated when his family were going through an extremely difficult time. So there are basically three legal ways Ronaldo's situation can legally play out. The first way is that this could be resolved by mutual agreement in the termination of Ronaldo's employment contract. This would be a potential win-win both for player and club. The club would be able to save on its huge wage bill and allow the manager to continue the transition into a high-pressing team, while at the same time respecting Ronaldo's achievements and legacy by allowing him to move on, either to be sold or, as unlikely as it might seem, be given a free transfer in the January window. This strategy would be achieved quietly, behind closed doors, and largely without further negative publicity, save for the final respectful goodbye statements from player and club. The second way this could play out or crash out is the nuclear option, that is Ronaldo unceremoniously being sacked. This would potentially be a complicated, messy and protracted affair, continuing the very public and yes, legal dispute involving accusations and counter-accusations for years to come. Who breached what terms of the contract? Manchester United may accuse Ronaldo of gross misconduct, thereby terminating the contract, which might suit Ronaldo's schedule. The employees may well focus their wrath accusing him of breaching particular terms likely to be in his contract, including the knowingly or recklessly saying something which is likely to bring the club into disrepute or cause damage to the club or its officers or employees. A term the club could easily argue has been breached by giving such an explosive interview. And if this does happen, don't be surprised if Ronaldo makes a counter legal accusation that the club and employer breached the contract by failing in its duties to take reasonable steps to protect his health and safety as an employee, by failing to give him care while he was experiencing very difficult family circumstances. That nuclear option means bad publicity, and that is not what either side, I expect, would want. The final legal way is for the club to keep Ronaldo by sitting around the table to resolve issues. This may be extremely unlikely given all that's been said and done. Sack, sell or keep Ronaldo. What do you think will happen next? Feel free to comment, follow, like and share.